Good morning, Standard 10 students. Today I shall continue with the third stanza of the 9 gold medals by David Rott. Okay. Now the loudspeaker called out the names of the runners, the 100 meters, the race to be run. And 9 young athletes stood there determined to poise for the sound of the gun. Now the names of the participants of the 100 meter race was announced. So both the event of the 100 meter race was announced, as well as the names of these athletes, those who are taking part in the 100 meter dash, their names were also announced. Now the people in the stadium heard the names loud and clear through the loudspeaker. So the names of the event and the names of the athletes were very clear. It was loud and clear through the loudspeaker. 9 young athletes stood at the starting block, at the starting point, calm and composed, with determination in their eyes, waiting for the sound of the gun. So now when you see any Olympic Games, when these runners, when they come to the starting point, you find them very cool, calm and composed, means they are full of concentration. Okay. And now, and determination is there inside them to win the medal. So the particular event and the names of the participants are announced. All eyes are on the runners and all ears for the signal to start, for the sound of the starting piston. Now poised ear means ready. Remain balanced in readiness means they're getting themselves positioned to start the 100 meter dash. The signal was given, the pistol exploded, and so did the runners on hearing the sound. So as soon as this is on your marks, set, and boom, the starting piston exploded, and the runners also, they shot out from the starting block. But the youngest among them stumbled and staggered, and he fell on his knees to the ground. Unfortunately, when everyone took off, the youngest of the 9 athletes, he stumbled, staggered, and he fell on his knees to the ground. Now you could imagine the feeling of that unfortunate young athlete who fell to the ground. It means that he was not able to cope up with the race, and he was going to lose the race. The official starter of the race gave the signal by firing the pistol. At the sound of the gun, all 9 swiftly shot out from the starting block. All of a sudden, the youngest among them, the 9, became unsteady, lost his balance, and fell on his knees in the track. So in the fourth stanza, we are paying attention to just before the pistol could go, and the way the athletes shot out from the starting block. But in that process, the youngest one stumbled and fell. He gave out a cry of frustration and anguish. His dreams and his efforts dashed in the dirt. But as sure as I'm standing here telling the story, now it's a strange one, but here's what occurred. Now, he, the youngest athlete, was very upset with what had happened and thinking all his dreams of a medal shattered. Cried out loudly, and everyone in the stadium saw and heard it. So the entire lot, the spectators, they all saw what had happened and how the young athlete fell and how he screamed. The poet says, David Roth, it was a strange and unfortunate thing, and now he narrates what happened after that. Okay. Now, cry of frustration means feeling of disappointment due to the failure of one's plan. So here he cried out because he was feeling disappointed due to the failure of his plan. What was his plan? To win the gold medal. Anguish means pain and disappointment. The meaning of anguish is pain as well as disappointment. Dashed means destroyed. You can underline these words and write the meanings. In the dirt means, hear what it means, as a result of falling on the ground. So when he fell on the ground, his body was already dirtied with the dirt on the tracks, as well as his dreams were also shattered and mixed with that dirt. I mean, everything had come to an end for him. His dreams were shattered. Okay. Now, what strange thing happened after he fell? The other eight athletes stopped in their tracks. So when they heard a loud cry, all the other eight athletes stopped and they turned around. The one who had trained for so long to compete. Now remember, it was not only that athlete who fell, his dreams were shattered. But here, the other eight athletes did not bother about winning the gold now, or gold, silver, or bronze. They had also taken a lot of pain, struggle, training, and all that. So they left all those, because they left all those things behind. They were also worked very hard to win a medal. But at that particular moment, they did not think about themselves. They all turned back. One by one, they turned around and came back to help him and lifted the lad to his feet. And they lifted the young boy, since he was the youngest athlete, they lifted him up to his feet. So now the other eight athletes, they did not bother about fulfilling their dreams. They also worked hard, they sweated out, they struggled, they trained themselves. But at that particular time, they did not bother. They left all that aside and they reached out to help this young boy. Then all nine runners joined hands and continued. All the nine runners held each other's hand. And now they continued the race. And most important thing is, now what you have got to remember is that they reduced the 100 meter dash into a walk. You will be asked this question. What were the strange things that occurred after the young athlete fell? So all the other 8 athletes, they went, they helped him out. And then the other strange thing is that they did not run the race. They walked together, holding each other's hand to the finishing line. And the banner above that said Special Olympics could not have been nearer the mark. Okay. Now, when they forgot the desire to be ahead of everyone else, the 9 of them held each other's hand and turned the 100 meter race into a walk to the finishing line. The poet says the banner above the stadium, which read Special Olympics in big letters, was justified by the 9 athletes' exemplary approach together towards the finishing line. Now the spectators are presented with new turns and twists as the actions of the athletes unfolded in front of their eyes. Their action is special, as the Special Olympics. The spirit of empathy is visible in a very special way. That's how the race ended, with 9 gold medals. They came to the finishing line holding hands still, and the banner above and 9 smiling faces said more than these words ever will. Said more than these words ever will. Now all of them came to the finishing line holding hands. The race ended with all 9 of them touching the tape at the same time. And thus, all of them won gold medals. The official decided that they should give all of them the gold medal. The banner in the stadium, Special Olympics, and the smiles on the faces of the 9 athletes expressed far better than words ever could say. All the 9 athletes displayed empathy, turning the Special Olympics into a truly special one. So now, we say action speaks louder than words. Now the way the other 8 athletes behaved or reacted after the falling of the youngest one, that impressed the spectators, the officials, everyone present in the stadium. They were very well, or they applauded for the exemplary actions that was performed by the other 8 athletes. And thus, the poem also gets its name as 9 gold medals. Okay. So now I think now the poetry is very clear. And if you still have doubts, then you are free to consult me. You can confide in me and I will definitely help you. Thank you.